the Old Testament, and he basically debunks Prophet Muhammad.
Who said he's mentioned?
Pardon?
Who said he's mentioned?
Yeah, says he's mentioned.
No, who said he's mentioned?
Quran, Surah 7, verse 157.
What does it say?
It says that the messenger is mentioned in the Torah and the Gospel.
Mentioned by name?
I don't know if it says.
You're talking Rambam right now?
Yeah, I'm talking.
What do you say?
So the Rambam, in his letter to the Yemenite Jews who were being forced to convert to Islam,
Jews being forced to convert to Islam?
Yeah,
always.
Yemen.
That's why my family left Morocco, my friend. Because the Muslims always make you convert.
Why were we in Morocco?
The church doesn't
have to. We were in the Arab lands before Islam.
Why were we in Morocco?
Because Yahudis have been in the...
No, why were we in Morocco?
What do you mean, why? That's where my family comes from.
No, how did you get to Morocco? From where?
Are you also Jewish?
Of course.
Can you not tell from his demeanor? Right, how did you get to Morocco?
So the Romans kicked us out of the land of Israel, Eretz Israel. We fled to Morocco.
Did you like a history lesson?
You asked how did I end up there?
Yeah. Well, what you've just said is completely wrong.
Why?
There were actually two,
why is that wrong?
Actually two times. You're both right. Because I know you're going to say from the Spanish Inquisition.
Yes.
No, I didn't. My family did not come from the Spanish Inquisition.
You're both right.
Because my family talks about remembering when the Sephardi Jews came into Morocco. My family remembers when the Sephardi
Jews... Your family remembers?
Of course.
Which member of your family remembers?
It's written down in history, my friend.
So which member of your family
remembers?
It's
probably an oral tradition.
So your family doesn't remember, you mean it's just in history? Nothing to do with your family?
No, my family also remembers. Oral
which
history.
Which member of your family remembers?
Oral history. Great, 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 great grandfather.
How do you know what they remember?
Because it's passed down in stories.
So it's hearsay from your ancestors?
It's not hearsay.
Okay.
Why is it hard for you to imagine that Jews predate Islam?
Say it again, sir.
Why is it hard for you to accept that Jews predate Islam in the Middle East?
I have no issue with that.
What?
I have no issue with that.
You probably do, yeah. North Africa, okay. They speak Arabic, they were forced to. The Berbers, the Arabs took over.
Can I just say something?
It's both right.
If you want to discuss with me, I don't mind. But leave your logical fallacies at the door.
What fallacies?
The straw man.
What?
The straw man fallacy.
What's that?
I never made that claim you just made. I didn't say I have a problem with Jews being Muslims. Did I? Did I make that claim?
I'm looking at you. You probably do. So.
No, did I make that claim?
Yeah, it seems like
no,
you are.
No, did I make that claim?
No, you didn't make
that claim. I didn't make that claim. Yet you address me as if I did.
Okay.
Which is a straw man logical fallacy.
Right.
So when I say to you, leave your logical fallacies at the door.
So you asked me how my family arrived in Morocco, right?
No, I'm saying to you.
Do you want to have a conversation like a normal person or not? I'm just trying to talk to you.
Yeah, but no, you're not talking to me. You're barking at me. You're telling me what I'm saying when I haven't said it.
Okay. So my family arrived in Morocco when the Romans kicked the Jews out of Eretz Israel, the land of Israel, thousands of years ago, 70 AD.
When was it?
70 AD.
Right. So they went to Morocco then?
What is today, modern day Morocco, yes.
So
before Islam was ever there.
For the benefit of anyone, before you interrupted, you made a claim that the Muslims are forcing Jews to convert.
They've always, in Yemen, in Syria, in Iraq, in Morocco, they've always forced us to convert.
Okay, so...
Maimonides talks about both.
No, let me just deal with that. Let me just deal with that particular point.
Even the Jews in the Quran mentioned...
Who told you this?
Bnei Yahudi.
Who told you this?
I've read the Quran. It's in history.
Where in the Quran does it say to force Jews to convert to Islam?
It said that there were some forced to convert to Islam.
Where in the Quran does it say that?
I don't know where exactly.
Well, you made the claim.
Yeah, I'll look it up right now.
Show me anywhere in the Quran where it says forced Jews to convert to Islam.
Do you not believe that Jews have ever been forced to convert to Islam? You don't believe that? You don't believe Muslims have said, oh, kafir, kafir, dimi, pay jizya, and they force you to...
Listen, you can make all the sound bites you like.
No. Do you
support what you're saying?
Do you not believe that?
And you support what you're saying with some proof?
Yeah.
Because you've made false assumptions, you've brought logical fallacies to the table. I thought you were going to come with a little bit of substance, and right now it's nothing. It's in the air. You're saying a lot.
I thought you knew history.
I'll just give you an issue lesson while you're looking, Joe. Yeah. Have you heard of a guy called Dr. Wasserstein?
Dr. what?
Wasserstein.
Wasserstein.
Yeah. Okay, Dr. Wasserstein is a Jewish historian, and he wrote an article in the Jewish Chronicle.
He's probably a self-hating Jew. He's going to use a Jew against other Jews. I'll give you some names of some Muslims. I gave you some names of some Muslims who said Islam is not a real religion.
If you challenge us, I don't mind. All right. But what he said, this is his claim. So, Jay Wasserstein, Dr. Wasserstein, in the Jewish Chronicle, did an article saying Islam saved the Jews. Yeah?
Well, I agree with part of that.
So basically, without Islam, Jews wouldn't exist today.
I disagree, but I agree with some of that.
No.
Because of the Ottoman Empire, they accepted the Jews after the Spanish Inquisition.
No. This was the claim made. Now, the question needs to be asked, how did the Muslims save the Jews from extinction? Now, it's going to be hard for you to answer that.
No, I can probably understand some of
it. No. Well, you made a claim that the Muslims are forcing Jews to convert, and at the same time...
To this day, by the way.
At the same time, you're agreeing that the Muslims saved the Jews from extinction.
Not all Jews. maybe 150,000 at most.
Okay.
And actually, in Bosnia, during the Holocaust, some Muslims also saved Jews.
Oh, okay.
So that's good.
I'll say it again.
Albania?
The Albanian Muslims are
amazing. So Dr. Wasserstein says this. If it wasn't for Islam, the Jews today would not exist.
That's heresy.
Right. Now you can challenge what Dr. Wasserstein, this historian, says. I don't mind. It's an article in the Jewish Chronicle.
What were the events that he said?
Allahu Akbar. I'm glad you asked. Okay. They were being massacred by the Christians in Spain.
That's, yeah, of course. And they fled to the Ottoman Empire.
No.
And the Sultan. Yeah,
no,
yeah.
There was no.
There was Jews in Germany.
Nothing to do with that. It's to do with the fact that the Muslims, when they went into Spain, yeah, they gave the Jews protection from Christian onslaught.
And do you know what happened to the Muslim who was the highest ranking official in the the Sultan's court in Southern Granada?
Long,
do you know what happened to him?
How long?
He got killed by Muslim mobs.
How long were the Jews protected by the Muslims in Spain?
I don't know. I don't know.
800 years. Now, Dr. Wasserstein, what he says is this. This gave the Jews the opportunity to flourish, to resurrect their history. And Jews from around Europe had a place of safety. Under whose protection? The Muslims.
In the Ottoman Empire.
No, it's not the Ottoman Empire.
Yes.
No, it's under the Moors.
No, no, no. The Moors were defeated by the Spaniards.
No, no, no.
Yes,
the Moors were defeated after 800 years. And what?
How did the Moors get there? Through jihad, by killing people. So,
no.
Yeah, of course. They're not natives. They're not
natives. Okay. You tell me how they got there. Because you seem to have all
the answers. North African. They committed jihad to get into Europe.
And who told you that?
That's history.
And where in history does it say that?
In every history book you read.
Name one history book that says that.
Any history book.